VST plugins are software add-ons that can be used to add a variety of different effects and instruments to digital audio workstations on Windows. They can be available for free or purchased from different companies. Today we'll be doing a basic tutorial on how to use these plugins and instruments that you can apply to basically any digital audio workstation you'll be using to record music in the home studio. The exact way this is done may change a little, but the basic idea of how it works will remain the same for whatever program you add them to. Many digital audio workstations used for home recording will include a variety of different plugins and instruments that are installed with the software. A lot of these are great starting points, especially for our mixing tools such as compression and equalization. However, there are a lot more options that are available online that you can download and then just add these for a little more customization to your software. VST plugins and instruments can be added to just about any digital audio workstation with a few exceptions. There are some digital audio workstations that are fully free, such as Cakewalk by BandLab, and there are some that are basically just demo versions, such as Persona Studio 1.4 and Pro Tools First. In these cases, it's not possible to install VST plugins and instruments in the software. That's one of the limitations, and we're stuck with the included plugins and instruments. Many of these programs also have a limited number of plugins and instruments, and this is one way to convince people to purchase the full version of the software. Just keep that in mind when deciding if trying to install VST plugins, since you need to make sure it's possible in your program first. There are many free plugins available from websites such as vstforfree.com, which just provide a collection of plugins from many different developers. From these websites, just download the plugin to the downloads folder on your computer. From here, I recommend finding a way to organize the plugins in a folder system on your computer. I have mine saved on an extra hard drive where I keep a lot of extra files, but you can save them anywhere as long as they're kept organized. For my organization, I have a few folders from videos I made, but I usually like to keep the plugins organized by developers. You can do it this way or by the type of plugins, such as keeping compressors or equalizers together. I like organizing by developers because sometimes you might get packages that hold a bunch of plugins of different types. What you do now is just take the plugin from the downloads folder and drag and drop it into the folder where you want to store the plugins. Some plugins may require you to run an installer to get them running. This is often those plugin packages that come with many plugins or plugins from developers that charge money for their software. In this case, it all works the same except you'll be running the installer instead. When running the installer, you'll often get the option to choose a folder to install the plugins in. Choose the folders where we'll be saving them, just like the others. Of course, only run programs like this from developers and sources that you trust. Depending on the developer, you may need to have some sort of licensing software running on your computer in order to keep the plugins activated. An example is the iLock License Manager, used by a lot of different developers. This manages some programs such as Pro Tools and plugins that are often paid, or some that are included with hardware such as the ones I receive with my Akai MIDI controllers. I have plugins from SoftTube and Sonovox that require this software to be running in order to work. Other plugins may require you to log into your account from the plugin itself in order to activate it. This is the case with some plugins I have from Traction, and the login process happens when you go to use the plugin for the first time from the digital audio workstation after it has been installed. From there, you may need to log back in every few weeks to keep it active, but this is a fairly simple process. Now to get the plugins to work, we have to tell our digital audio workstation where the plugins are located. This is the step that will differ between different digital audio workstations, and you may have to look through some of the settings to figure this out for your particular software, but it's usually very easy to find. This is usually from the drop-down section at the top of the screen. Within the settings, there's usually a section for plugins. From here, there's usually some sort of field that allows us to browse for folders on our computer where our plugins are located. The default should be the folder where the plugins included with the software are found. What we want to do is add a new folder. We'll click the Add or Browse button, whatever is in our software, and navigate to that folder where we organized all the plugins and add it. The digital audio workstation now sees this as a location where all the plugins are stored. Now, as long as the plugins work properly, they should be available to use in the digital audio workstation. Our normal plugins that are applied to audio are found as plugins under the insert section of the track, just like the plugins that would be included with the software. Sometimes, though, they won't be organized like the built-in plugins and might be found under the other section and then be organized by the developer. Virtual instruments are also installed in the same way, but they are then accessed from an instrument track, and we select the plugin when we create the instrument track. Then to get it to play, we just use a MIDI controller to input notes or add notes on the piano roll. These virtual instrument plugins then give us an audio output from the MIDI input. So this basically covers everything for installing VST plugins and instruments in a digital audio workstation. A lot of these techniques can be applied to just about any digital audio workstation, that way we can use third-party plugins in whatever DAW we're using. Thanks for checking out this video on installing VST plugins and instruments in a digital audio workstation. If this video helped you out, don't forget to give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and press the bell icon to get notified whenever a new video is released. You can also check the video description for social media links to keep up to date on all our new content.